Today we look at catching. If the ultimate goal for me as a coach is to get my player performing an overhead catch, assertively moving their head towards the object that's coming their direction and grasping it in midair, we must look at things from a couple of key areas. These key areas are our teaching points of that skill and how we cue it, building a confidence and a bravery in dealing with an object coming their direction and dispelling the fear that they'll be hit by it and hurt, and then building ball sense through adaptations and progressions and ball contacts from that point on. The key teaching points for the Tiger Claw catch would be same hand, same leg, whichever hand I'm catching with, and fingers pointed to the sky, I should be able to see the back of my hand. My Tiger Claw catch deals with everything above shoulder height, stand across eye level, and then work in this area above our head. Building bravery, getting the point across to our players that if I turn and grimace and worry about the beanbag hitting me, the thing that I will worry about will actually happen. And the chances of me catching the beanbag because I can't see it are much, much lower. But if I keep my eye on it and track it with my hand, the tracking of it with the hand being the key part, at least if I don't catch it, I can stop it hitting me, but I'm giving myself the best chance to catch it. Be positive in our language. Where on the stages of development are your players regards catching? We're working backwards from size 5 to 4 to 3 to smart touch to quick touch to first touch, performing that Tiger Claw catch. Then we're looking at building the gap between first touch and quick touch by the use of beanbags. What's a large enough target that they'll still be able to catch it, but small enough that it would fit in their hand? Stages of catching with a first touch sitter. Throwing and double-handed catching to chest. Throwing and double-handed catching away from body. Throwing and single-hand catch into chest on both sides. And then working at single-hand catch away from body. Bouncing catch, throwing catch. If I find it difficult to deal with a first touch sitter, move back to a football that's a right size for your player. A soccer ball or a proper full-size football would be too heavy and hard to deal with, and we won't be able to build that confidence and bravery. Work back from there to balloons or small balls. If I deal with a fully inflated balloon, I can deflate the balloon to make it that little bit more difficult all the way along because it will drop quickly.